Welcome to another video of Cat and Sorcery. Imagine you have a number of models that share many similarities, but they also have differences. Managing all these different versions may be challenging, but not for SOLIDWORKS users. We have configurations. Until the end of this video, I'm going to explain the fundamentals of configurations, show you what you can configure in your models, and show different ways of configuring your models. Before we begin, make sure you like and subscribe to my channel for more SOLIDWORKS content. Configurations are variations of a part or an assembly model in SOLIDWORKS. The main advantage of configurations is that we use the same part or assembly document to store all these different variations. Configurations can be created, managed, and accessed from the Configuration Manager tab. When a new part is created, it has only one configuration, named default. It's good practice to name your configurations properly. To add a new configuration, you can right-click anywhere on the Configuration Manager area and select from the right-click menu the Add Configuration option. The Property Manager opens, and you can define a name for the new configuration and a description. Click the green checkmark when the configuration is ready. The active configuration appears with a green checkmark on the left of its name. I'll return to the Feature Manager. On the top level of the design tree, we can see that the name of the active configuration appears in brackets. I can choose any dimension that I want to modify, as I would do with any part. If the part has more than one configuration, a new option appears on the right of the Modify window. Before I modify this dimension, it is important to define if I want the input value to be applied to all, this configuration only, or to specific configurations. I select this configuration before I input any value within the Modify window. Suppressing a feature removes it effectively from the model geometry without deleting it. To suppress a feature, simply click on it. From the menu that appears, choose the Suppress option. Suppressed features appear in gray in the Feature Manager design tree. The opposite process is called unsuppress. By clicking on a suppressed feature, choose the unsuppress option. Let's add more configurations to the model, but this time, let's make it faster. By right-clicking on a dimension, I will choose the Configure Dimension option from the right-click menu. This opens the Modify Configurations dialog box. This shows the names of the configurations in rows and the names of dimensions in columns. By double-clicking on another dimension, I can add it in the column list. By clicking on the Create New Configuration, I can directly create a new configuration and apply any values I want. This also applies to features. By right-clicking on a feature, I can choose the Configure Feature option. There, I can check the Suppress checkbox and suppress the feature for each configuration. Same applies, of course, for unsuppressing. We can also create configurations with different materials. Simply choose the Edit Material option and go to the Config option. As previously, we can modify the material for all, specified, or this configuration. I'll set the same materials for all configurations. Parts and assemblies have both custom and configuration properties. This means that each configuration can have different values for specified properties. This can be extremely useful in builds of materials. I can also alter the appearance of the model based on the configuration. Just make sure you right-click on the Display State, choose Properties, and then mark the Link to Display States option if it's not already checked. Then proceed to any change you wish to make to each configuration. Configuration tables represent the configurations in a tabular form for easier management. I can access the configuration table from the Configuration Manager. From here, I can perform the same actions as in the previous window. Another great way to manage configurations is through the design table. Design tables basically build configurations of parts or assemblies by utilizing an embedded Excel worksheet. For this demonstration, I'll keep it simple. A worksheet appears like in Excel. This sheet is a little fragile, so I prefer to close it by left-clicking anywhere in my viewport once. What I prefer to do instead is to open the same worksheet in an Excel window. Once the worksheet opens in Excel, I can copy and paste a row to create a new configuration. I can modify values, modify properties, etc. Regardless, this is a great tool, especially for non-SolidWorks users that are familiar with the Excel spreadsheets. Let's see what configurations can do in assemblies. Once I insert a part within an assembly, I can choose the configuration of that part directly from the Property Manager, even if it's dragged from the design library. I can add configurations in the same way I do in part documents. And of course we can configure mates so they can be suppressed or unsuppressed for different configurations. We can also create derived configurations below our main configurations. And that was a short demonstration of SolidWorks configurations. To sum up, configurations offer easier model management, more efficient use in assembly, less disk space consumption, and generally, better performance. If you liked this video, don't forget to give thumbs up and subscribe for more SolidWorks content. Until next time, thanks for watching.